Hello again, Josh here from Absolute. In our last episode, we saw all kinds of cyber threats. In this episode, we'll see how those threats can get to the goods. Let's look at phishing, the most common tool cyber criminals use to get access to our systems. And we've all seen it, the email from your bank or a company you patron asking you for information, please update your account or profile or membership or something. The logos, the font styles, they look real. And there's a button staring back at you. What is it about people and buttons? There is this unmistakable urge to click. And now that you've scratched that itch and you've clicked, the attacker gets a toehold to push malware, ransomware, or even grab control of the device directly. Phishing is the most widely used weapon for cyber attacks for one single, very important reason. It works. It exploits our most basic instincts, curiosity, cooperation, trust, and a willingness to share and help. And when we fall for these deceptions, we are likely to play host to some unwelcome guests in our IT environment. Malware. Malware is a smashed word coming from malevolent, meaning bad, and software from the word software. Malware tends to come in four forms. One, viruses. Two, worms. Three, Trojans. And four, hostage takers, or ransomware. Viruses are aptly named because they infect the system and interact with normal processes to either get the user to do something to give access or to disable the system in some way to make it unusable. Worms are designed with the expressed intent to replicate and spread to other systems. Like viruses, these pesky malwares corrupt the host system, but are tailored for reproduction, and thus they're more damaging. Compounding the sadism, we have Trojans. These malwares look like approved apps and softwares, like a printer driver. So they're not easily detected by antivirus. Once installed, they replicate and forge onward to other resources playing the same trick. And by now, most of us have heard of the last of these weapons, ransomware. The malware designed to lock your files and data until you pay a fee, usually in the form of cryptocurrency, so it can't be traced. But the good news, of course, is that no phishing scam or malware is effective without an existing vulnerability. Once again, we see why persistent endpoint visibility and control is so essential. Unless we can see our trouble spots and quickly remove risk, we are bound to fall victim to these attack vectors. In our next episode, we'll continue looking at notorious threats, botnets. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.